and retain your FM team with ProFM. Randy Olson, Vice President of Development with ProFM, will deliver the presentation. Randy, over to you.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Lori. And really excited to be back here at FacilitiesNet and walk through our program. So what I'd like to do is start off with kind of giving you the pathway for where we're going today. And on an annual basis, we partner up with FacilitiesNet and we go out to the global facility management audience and ask them their top challenges and kind of the things they're dealing with looking into the end of the new year. I'm going to share some data points from that to kind of set the table for the importance of training and credentials for both employers and for staff. And then I'm going to talk about how to identify your team's gaps, your knowledge and skills gaps against the ProFM body of knowledge, which I'll describe here in a minute. And then talk to you about how to implement a ProFM training program, a credential training program at your organization. We'll wrap up with a special offer and resources at the end. And of course, as Lori and Paul both stated, we'll do Q&A at the end as well. So with that, I'll launch right into kind of the top facility management challenges for 2023. So as I mentioned, we go out to the global facility management audience on an annual basis, and we ask them the challenges they're looking at going into the new year. And these have been pretty consistent over the past couple of years, but what's risen to the top, and probably no surprise to everyone on the call, is getting qualified staff, getting good staff, and then retaining those staff, so keeping them on your team. Second, this year in 2023 is budgeting and funding, also probably not a surprise to everyone here. And then associated with that, the rising costs and inflation that we're all dealing with in both our professional and personal lives. So a couple data points from the survey. So this year, folks that were surveyed, 54% of the facility managers that were surveyed considered leaving their position or have left their position within the past year. Just incidentally, comparing that to last year's results, that's down a little bit from last year in 2022, which was 66%. But still a significant problem. So over half of your staff is considering leaving. And then 50% of employers expect to have open FM positions in 2023. So half the organizations out there think there's going to be open positions at their organization. So ways to improve or retain those folks then. And again, feedback from the global facility management audience here. So the top three factors that would keep employees at their current organization is work-life balance. So, balancing out that work and life, opportunities for professional development and training, and then of course, increased compensation or benefits. And this mix has changed over the past year, where work-life balance bubbled to the top along with professional development and training. Went ahead of increased compensation and benefits. So there are effective ways to keep your talented people at your organizations. So then what is the value of FM training to your for employers and staff at your organizations? So what do managers say about this? Well, managers say that it results in better job performance, increased competence, increased credibility in the delivery of solutions, and then increased job satisfaction. From an employee standpoint, from a staff standpoint, also increased credibility, better job performance, career advancement, so looking to move up the chain, and then up to date on developments in FM. So, these are the kind of the top benefits, if you will, of training. So 81% of FM managers say that a credential or qualification is a important factor in hiring or promoting FM staff. Okay, so this is a up 5% from 2022. So increasingly, education and training is becoming more important in looking at hiring and or promoting. And then 41% of credentialed FMs say their credential resulted in an advancement opportunity within their organization. So owning that and getting that and achieving that helped them advance in their career. So let's move on and shift gears here a little bit and talk about how to identify your team's knowledge and skills gaps. What I'd like to do first is introduce to you the ProFM body of knowledge, and this provides the basis for the delivery of the education and the credential program that is the ProFM. This body of knowledge is based on global standards that are delivered by ISO, so the ISO 41000 series of standards, and then the U.S. standard of Federal Building Personnel Training Act, or the FBPTA. So that is our key inputs into this body of knowledge. That body of knowledge then was globally validated across the global and broad facility management industry to ensure that these are the knowledge, skills, and abilities that are needed by facility managers today and into the future. The way the body of knowledge is structured is into four functional knowledge areas of asset management, risk management, business management, and operations and maintenance. There's 4 to 6 topics within each one of those functional FM knowledge areas. I always like to refer to these functional FM knowledge areas really as the technical skills, the technical things that you need to deliver on as a facilities manager. And then threaded across that are really soft skills or cross-functional competencies of communication, sustainability, quality, innovation, and collaboration. So meaning that when you deliver a technical solution, we need to ensure that we're taking into account good communication and all these cross-functional competencies that deliver the best and most effective solution to your constituencies. So this body of knowledge represents the 24 things that are based on global standards and broadly validated by the broad and global facility management audience and provides the basis for the ProFM program. Now, as an organization, you can measure your team and your individual skills against this body of knowledge. And this is done through a self-assessment tool that's delivered free on our website. So it incorporates both manager input and individual team members input into kind of where they see themselves being most effective in regards to those 24 things. So again, it measures their confidence and experience against those 24 topics in the ProFM body of knowledge. And then that helps prioritize those training opportunities by bringing all those inputs from all the individual team members, the manager view into that, into one nicely structured report that is delivered to the team. So this then provides that basis and that opportunity to really focus in on the training opportunity delivered. Everything that I'm talking about, to include the survey that we delivered, this map your gap teams, or this team assessment and individual map your gap, is all delivered on profmi.org. Those are free tools that are available to you that you can get started on today if you like. All right, so let's move on and let's talk about then how to implement the ProFM training credential and training program at your organization. So with our program, there's three ways in which somebody can go through that program. And one, the first way is really through a pure self-study option. So what's included in here are the reading materials, the online study tools. I'll walk you through this platform here in a minute of those tools. And then the ProFM final assessment are all delivered within the program. It doesn't matter how you choose to go through this. Those tools are always consistent, whether it be self-study, as I just talked about, which is a purely self-paced option and self-directed option. So you study as you can. If you're a person that's very disciplined around this, this is a great way to go. taking that self-study option then and adding some coaching is our coach self-study option. So the self-study materials, again, those same tools, plus seven online instructor QA sessions, really an intro on the front end, a walk through each one of those five modules that I walk through in the body of knowledge, and then a wrap up at the end, provide those seven online instructor Q&A sessions. This is a great option for folks that are very time constrained, but also need a little bit of instruction along the way. So that coach self-study option is a great option for you. And then last, we have a full instructor-led option that are typically delivered through partners, through college university partners, training partners that deliver the ProFM program. Takes those same self-study materials, plus a live or online course, or sometimes that's delivered hybrid. Some live in classroom, some online. So with that, there's a lot of benefit in those instructor-led classes. So you have the opportunity to network with all your classmates, you have the opportunity to network with your instructor and learn from your instructor, and the amount of expertise in the room and the experience in the room really provides for great peer discussion and great case studies and great learning. So those are three delivery options for the program. So what's in the program then? So as I talked about earlier, that body of knowledge, that ProFM body of knowledge with the 24 things provides the basis for all the materials in the program that is delivered. So there's a set of reading materials for each one of those five areas. So a module, a book, if you will, for the cross-functional competencies, and then one for each one of the four FM functional knowledge areas. Those reading materials are delivered electronically and then optionally in print. So if you want to get printed modules, we can have those shipped directly to you. So that's where all that knowledge is kind of kept and gained within the program, in those reading materials. There's over 1,000 pages of content within those five modules. Then I'm going to walk through these in a minute, but there's a set of online study tools. So this is a platform, a very inherent, a very intelligent platform that you log into, and it walks you through kind of each piece of the program and helps you create a learning path into the program and helps kind of walk you through it. I'll go through this in a minute. And then last, then you need to be assessed. So the final assessment is delivered within that same online online platform. To get into that platform, you get a user ID and password that's unique to you. So you get the reading materials, get the online study tools, and access to those online final assessments. It's delivered in two pieces. The assessments are delivered in two pieces: pure knowledge recall, and then also situational. So taking not only what you know, but how you apply it to real world scenarios. Upon successful completion of that, then you earn the globally recognized ProFM credential. So let's take a quick walk through the platform, and then I will certainly address as many questions as I can here at the end. So as I talked about earlier, you can log in from really any device anywhere. It's a size such that you can use this on a mobile device. It makes it very usable there. So just get a connection, have access through user ID and password, and you have access into those online tools. So the steps here, the learning path, are clearly laid out in that you want to assess your current knowledge. That's done through a pretest that I'll dig into here in a minute. Study for success. So go through those reading materials, either electronically online through the e-reader or with printed materials, and then pass your exam and earn your credential. So those study tools are all included within this online program. So the first step to that then is to assess your current knowledge. So you start that by taking the pretest. So this assesses what you know today against the ProFM body of knowledge and gives you a nice report then based on that. Next, then you would go into the study tools and you would use the reading materials to gain knowledge. But then in addition, there's a whole set of checkpoints along the way with quizzes. So each kind of section module has a quiz to make sure that you're gaining the knowledge needed as you walk through the program to go get that seal of approval of at the end of the ProFM credential. In addition, there's flashcards here for study purposes. So there's a whole suite of tools that help you walk through and assess where you're at and make sure that you're gaining knowledge along the way. So as I've talked about a couple of times, those reading materials are delivered online through an e-reader or in printed modules. So you get going and you complete that reading, you do those checkpoints with those quizzes along the way to make sure that you're making the appropriate knowledge gains and the appropriate competency gains needed to then deliver better solutions to your organizations. So then I talked earlier about the retention and comprehension with quizzes along the way. The quizzes provide you feedback on the appropriate answer with rationale. So as you answer a question, this is an example question here. As you answer a question, it will provide you immediate response on whether that was correct or incorrect. And then the rationale, and then the associated content within the program where you can go back and research that. So this is a great way to systematically and through really manageable bite-sized chunks, get through the program and deliver, and then be able to deliver, better solutions at the end of this. All right, and then last in the platform, you need to prove it out, right? So this provides access to those two parts of the assessment that I talked about. Again, all in one program here, reading materials, online tools, and assessment, all delivered as an all-in-one program and broken into two parts. So pure knowledge recall and then application. So meaning, have I gained knowledge, but then am I able to apply it to real world scenarios and solve problems more effectively as a facilities manager? With this program, you can retake the exams as many times as you needed. So if you're not successful the first trip through, that's okay. You can take it multiple times at no additional cost. So everything within the ProFM is included within the ProFM program. So once you've completed the program, you, with no additional fees, are granted the globally recognized ProFM credential. We provide a registry. So if you want to opt into that registry and be recognized for folks that are, potentially looking to promote or hire you, you can do that. And then you'll also receive a printed certificate signed by our chairman of our board, Stormy Friday. So credentials valid for 3 years. There are some maintenance requirements along the way. So 45 professional development units that can be gained through speaking, through teaching, through writing articles, from working in the profession. So many different ways to accomplish and stay current on the ProFM. With that, I'd like to talk to you just briefly about a special offer for joining today. So as I talked about earlier, we are proud partners of FacilitiesNet and FM Prime. And FM Prime members receive a $500 discount on the ProFM credential program. This link is included at the bottom here for you to get more information about FM Prime and get that discount. So we encourage you to do that, to get involved with FM Prime and get involved with ProFM. And then just a few free resources. So I talked earlier about the resources that are available on profmi.org. So that map your gap, that team assessment is available there at this link. The training outlook survey, that survey that I talked about, that I referenced some data points. Incidentally, there's a lot more data points in that survey. So it's an important thing for you to review and download. And these are all free, by the way. And then last, if you want to try out some of the questions. There's 10 free ProFM practice questions. So this highlights three of the free resources that are available. There's a whole number of additional resources available to you out there on the site. So with that, I want to thank you very much for joining us. I think we're right within the time, right, Lori? So happy to take on any questions over the next couple of minutes here and get you off on the rest of your day.
Great, thanks, Randy. Just a reminder, any questions for Randy, just navigate to the Q&A at the bottom of your screen and type in your question. So first question is, if my company wanted to offer this training to a few of our FMs, do they have to be in the same place or can they do the training online?
So great question. And typically folks that offer it to a team, they're seldom in the same place. So they can certainly do it online. As I talked about, you could do that through self-study and you could have a little study group there. You could get a ProFM instructor and do a coach session specific to your organization, but they don't have to be in the same location. If you want to do it a full-blown class, you could also do that in either hybrid or fully online way of doing that.
Okay, next question. Someone is requesting, will you please show the slide shown before the question slide? I think they want to go back to.
Sure, let me give that a shot here. Before the question slide. This one?
Maybe it was the last one. Cindy, if you know which slide it was or what information was on the slide, that might be helpful, but we can certainly get back to that. Another question is, how long does it usually take a person or a team to get through the program? And then how long do we have access to the training?
Yeah, so let's take the easy part of that question. We'll talk about access. So access is provided for 12 months. So you get a full year access into the program. And that's typically more than enough time to get through. Each individual and then the team. Okay, so I think I'm getting some clarification on what slide it is too here. I'll go back to that here in a minute. So each individual, you know, it's really variable on the amount of time, and it really on the average is about 60 to 80 hours of time to fully get through the program and be successful at the end. So gain all that knowledge, use the tools and be successful at the end. So that's typical. If you do a full in classroom course for your team, that's typically 30 to 35 hours of time in the classroom. And of course, there's outside study as well. So hopefully that helps answer that. It really comes down, we provide a tool that helps you plan that out as well. So based on how you get through the pretest and your results of the pretest, it helps you with areas you need to focus on. And I'm going to try to get to the slide that I believe is the one we're looking for. Is it this one?
The slide showing the FM survey info link.
Yep. So I think it's this slide.
And we will be sending a copy of the presentation to everyone that did join us today. And then I think one last question, Randy. Can I take this training by myself or does it have to be with a team?
Yeah, you can absolutely do it as an individual, and several people do. Or you can do that as with part of your with your team, all of your team, or part of your team as at your organization. So, really variable based on how you'd like to do that. But keeping in mind that the tools are always consistent, so you always get the reading materials, the access to the online tools, and the final assessments, no matter how you choose to go through it.
Okay, great. And then, Randy, any final thoughts for the audience?
Yeah, I think there's just a lot of really good information out on profmi.org to download and have access to. If you have questions, you know, certainly reach out to us. We're happy to help. And, you know, thanks to the great FacilitiesNet team for inviting us back. And Paul and Lori, thanks so much for being great hosts for the Democast today.